Hello guys, welcome to another video. In this video we are going to learn what is the difference between comparable interface and comparator interface in Java. We'll see the implementations with practicals. So without wasting much more time, let's start the video here. So here, as you can see, I have prepared some ready-made materials for you guys for your better understanding and my time saving purpose. So today's topic will be comparable and comparator interfaces. So first of all, we will understand what is comparable in Java. Okay, so here just read this, because it's always good to read the definition before understanding anything. So you can say, as the name itself suggests, comparable is an interface which defines a way to compare an object with other objects of same type. Okay, it helps to sort the objects that have self tendency to sort themselves. Okay, the objects must know how to order themselves. Okay, example, you can take roll number, age, salary, anything. Okay, so this interface is found in java.lang package and contains only one method, nothing but compare to method. So comparable is not capable of sorting the objects on its own, but the interface defines a method int compare to, which is responsible for sorting purpose. Okay, so after reading this definition, you must be thinking that what is compare to method, what is the logic behind this, and how it works. Okay, so just stop thinking on that, because I am going to explain that compare to method only. So you can suggest it as a method only, having return type integer. This method is used to compare two objects. One is our given object and another will be our argument object. Okay, so you can say it will return integer value as positive number, as negative number, or zero. Okay, so we will see that later. So you can say we have completed the definition part. Okay, so here I have written some syntax. Just read this once, no need to think much on it. We will see in practicals with a better manner. Okay, so you can say here the s1 object is our current object. Okay, and the passing object which we are passing to compare is s2. Okay, so that's it all about comparable interface in Java. We have read and understood the definitions, and we studied something about the compare to method. Okay, so we can now just move to the comparator part. Okay, after that we will do some programmatic implementations of those two interfaces. So here you can say, what is a comparator in Java? Okay, so you know that also. Okay, comparator is a interface used to order the objects of specific class. Okay, this interface is found in java.util package. So it contains two methods. So you can say one method is compare method, another method is overridden equals method. So here you can see compare method is having two arguments, object 1 and object 2. So you can imagine now, yeah, your thinking process is 100% correct. Okay, it will take two objects and it will use those objects for accessing the class members, and it will compare those members and return the value. Okay, so that's it. So here you can read these definitions. The first method, compare, as I have already said, compares its two input arguments and showcases the output. It returns negative numbers, positive integers, or you can say zero, to state whether the first argument is less than, equals, or greater than the second one. So here you can see second method, equals, having one argument, requires an object as a parameter and shows if the input object is equal to the comparator, the method will return true. Okay, so only if the mentioned object is also comparator, the order remains the same as the comparator. Okay, yeah, this is all about the theoretical part. We have learned about comparable and comparator interfaces. So just let's move to the programmatic part. So here you can take a project, you can say comparator and comparable. Yeah, that's it. Inside that we will take a package, I will say model. Okay, so here we can take example of mobile. Okay, so I will just create a mobile class. Inside that I want to store brand, again string model, you can say price. Okay, so here I am taking integer for price instead of double for your better understanding. So I will take RAM and camera. Okay, which I will store in MPs, megapixels. So here you can say constructor, just delete this super call. We will generate some getter setter methods, select all. Yeah, so we got our getter setter here, two string method. Yeah, with this we have completed our mobile class perfectly. So we will develop a test class now. So just create a package here. I will say com.div.test. Yeah, inside that you can take a class. Here you can say test, generate main method. Fine. Yeah, here I will say comparable test. Yeah, you have to make our mobile test eligible for compare. So here you can say implements comparable of type mobile, okay. So that's it. Generate unimplemented methods. So here you can change this logic of compare to method, okay. So here I will say this dot price minus argument object dot price, okay, o dot price. So this will return the difference as integer is the return type. Fine. So here inside our test class you can create an array list of type mobile. I will say list equals to new array list of, okay. Yeah, that's it. So here I can add list.add. So here I will create an object of our mobile class and I will pass inside the add method only. So here you can see the order of our constructor. Yeah, that's it. Here you can say brand apple, model equals to iPhone X. Here price 90,000. You can say 4GB RAM and 12MP camera, okay. So like this we can add more new mobile of, you can say Xiaomi K20 Pro. You can say 30,000, 8GB RAM, 48MP camera. You can add more new mobile of, you can say OnePlus. Yeah, here you can say 8 Pro. Fine. Here you can say price 50,000, camera RAM is equal to 6GB, camera 64. So here again add another one. I will say Xiaomi again, Mi 10, 50,000, 12GB RAM, 108MP camera. Fine. Yeah, with this you can say we have created four mobile objects and store in array list, okay. So here you can say collections dot sort method you can call, okay, pass the list for sorting operation. So here you can see the sort method logic, okay, extends comparable and all is the logic. So just you can say for mobile colon, you can say list sees out mobile, okay. It will print because of our two string method. So here you can see our mobile objects are sorted by price, okay, because we have written the logic inside our compare to method to sort as price, okay. So here you can say this dot RAM or dot RAM, so it will sort now by RAM, okay. So here you can see, yeah, just let me show you in the big screen. So here you can see 4GB RAM, 6GB RAM, 8GB RAM and 12GB RAM. It means it's sorting by RAM, okay, ascending order, okay. Yeah, that's it all about our comparable test class. So I will take another test class for comparator, okay. So first of all I will take some comparators. So I will take com.div.comparators, okay. So instead that we can take our comparator class. I will say RAM comparator, okay. Just take some more comparators. I will say brand comparator. Again you can say camera comparator, okay. So we will develop these comparators. So here inside RAM comparator you can say implements comparator of type mobile, okay. Yeah, that's it. You can override compare method. So here you can see it's our compare method. Here you can write this logic: if object 1 dot get RAM less than object 2 dot get RAM, then return -1, okay. So next one you can see, if greater than, then return positive number, okay. So else return 0. Yeah, else block will execute when two mobile objects RAM value will be same, okay. So here you can say camera comparator implements comparator of mobile. Yeah, that's it. Here we can compare method. You can say if object 1 dot get camera, same logic, less than object 2 dot get camera, return negative number. Here you can say get camera greater than o2 dot get camera, return 1, okay. So else return 0. Fine. So here we have to change our logic because brand is not a integer value, okay, it's a string value. So here we have already overridden the compare to method inside our mobile. So here we can use that method for brand comparator, okay. So implements comparator of type mobile. Here you can override compare method. Here inside that you can say return o1.getBrand.compare to method and just pass the o2 get brand, okay. So that's it. Yeah, this is an important example when interviewer will ask you how we can use comparable and comparator at once. So you can give that example, okay. Yeah, we can now take our comparator test class. Here generate the main method. I will copy the object creation statements, okay. So here just say paste. Yeah, after this you can say if you want to sort your mobile objects using camera specifications. So here I will say sort by camera. So first step will be you have to create an object of camera comparator. Yeah, just let me write here, create an object of camera comparator, fine. Yeah, next step we can say, yeah, just let me arrange this. Yeah, next step you can say you have to call collection dot sort method, okay. After that you can say just print the sorted list, okay. Yeah, that's it. We will perform these steps. So here you can say sorted by camera, fine. So here I will just keep a space. Yeah, after that you can say camera comparator cc equals to new camera comparator, fine. Yeah, we have created our camera comparator object. Here just call collection.sort method. You have to select this one, two arguments. So just pass this list and comparator, okay. So here you can say for mobile colon list, you can print the mobile object, okay. Yeah, after this just run the application. Here you can see the mobiles are sorted with camera 12, 48, 64 and 108 MP, okay. So that's it all about using camera comparator, okay. Here you can say sorted by brand, okay. Yeah, same you can say brand comparator. I will say BRC brand comparator BRC, okay. Yeah, just pass the BRC here as comparator. Yeah, here you can see the new outputs. Our mobile objects are sorted with brand, okay, AOX, okay, in alphabetical order. So here, yeah, one more comparator is left, nothing but RAM comparator. You can use that by your own. So I will just paste it here. I will say divide, fine. So here let's learn how to use comparator using Lambert expression, okay. So I will say here brand comparator LBRC, okay. Otherwise we can take our RAM comparator example, okay. So here you can say sorted by RAM, fine. Just delete the RAM comparator because we will develop by using Lambda expression. So here you can say comparator RAM comparator equals to, yeah, don't be worried if you don't know about Lambda expressions, okay. I will come with a new video soon on the topic of Lambda expressions only. So here you can say just open and close this process. Inside this you can pass the argument. Here you can say arrow mark, just open the body here. So inside this body you can write return statement. You can say return m2, yeah, just mention the type here mobile, okay. Yeah, here you can say m2.getRAM minus m1.getRAM, okay. Just end with a semicolon, fine. So here you can say this RAM comparator, okay. Yeah, here you can see the result is coming in descending order, okay. So just change this to m1 and this one to m2, just say run, fine. It's coming in ascending order. So we have successfully sorted our mobile object by RAM type using Lambda expressions. So that's all about today's video, guys. If you like this video, give a thumbs up and please subscribe to the channel so that it will motivate me a lot. Yeah, that's all for the day. We will meet in another video soon.